this school called Togo International Children's Center started off with about 60 kids. They're mostly orphans in the village, and they started to educate them. And through sponsorships and things like that, the school has grown to over 800 kids at this particular campus.
One of their issues is clean water. Right now they have a well that digs down 200 feet. If they're out of energy or if they don't have the diesel fuel, they cannot pump this well. It's too deep to do by hand. So they end up going to the marsh and drinking that water. That's highly unhealthy.
What we have designed and developed here is a DC microgrid based on renewable energy, so you see the solar panel here, and battery energy storage. And so what this does is this is a complete power system designed this particularly for them. So what it does is it actually tracks all the power that's flowing through our system. We have different voltage levels, different things like that.
We decided that bringing electricity to a school of children would allow them to get computers, to get access to the internet, to get access to education, but they need electricity. So our goal is to get the funding and then deploy the system, go there, install it.
This is a 100 watt monocrystalline solar panel. It's rated at 100 watts. The maximum power point voltage for this particular panel is 18.5 volts.
This is a Raspberry Pi, which is basically just a mini computer, costs about $35.
The best case scenario is we go there and we find all the components we need locally. And the reason for that is because the shipping costs to get something like this, a 3 to 5 kilowatt system with the PV panels and the energy storage over to Uganda, is not really cost effective. I think when I looked at it last, it was somewhere around the vicinity of $4,000 just to ship the solar panels alone. So anything we can get locally is definitely better.